हेलो स्टूडेंट, गुड मॉर्निंग। इन टुडेज लेक्चर ऑफ फार्माकोलॉजी वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट ए मेजर एंटीबायोटिक दैट इज नोन एज क्लोरम्फेनिकल। क्लोरम्फेनिकल द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस लेक्चर इज वी स्टडी अबाउट द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ एक्शन एंड एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ द क्लोरम्फेनिकल। What are the adverse factor contraindication of the use of the chloramphenicol? Then how we monitor and see the toxicity of chloramphenicol and what are the use of chloramphenicol? First of all, we see the structure of chloramphenicol. Chloramphenicol having a simple structure made up of a nitrobenzene ring bonded with the non-ionic chlorine. It consists two unusual component. One is nitro group, secondly dichloroacetyl group. The molecule possess two asymmetric carbon atom. As a result, it gives four optical isomer, out of which dextrothioisomer is antibiotically active. Chloramphenicol is a broad spectrum antibiotic active against gram positive, gram negative bacteria, include Rickettsia. It is also effective against the Haemophilus influenzae, and chloramphenicol has a broad spectrum activity. The antibiotic used to prevent incorporation of hemoglobin by blood cell lead to a plastic anemia, cause thrombocytopenia and leukocytopenia. Certain allergic response or neurotoxic reactions are there. The chloramphenicol, like other antibiotics as streptomycin, gentamicin, tetracycline, erythromycin, it inhibits the protein synthesis. It binds to the 23rd subunits of rRNA and 50 subunit of bacterial ribosome, inhibit the action of peptidyl transferase enzyme. By that, it lead to formation of a peptide bond, thereby lengthen the polypeptide by one amino acid rest. As you see in the picture, the mechanism of action, the polypeptide chain, by when we see the 50 subunit, it will also affect the action on the peptidyl transferase. Chloramphenicol having a certain major side effect. These are damage to the bone marrow, lead to cause plastic anemia, in usually reserved for the treatment of serious and life-threatening infection like typhoid fever. It will act by block the peptidyl transferase enzyme and inhibit the protein synthesis. The chloramphenicol can administer as a topically, eye or ear drop, parenterally, as intravenously, then as infusion or a oral capsule. The therapeutic dose is not more than 50 mg per kg per day. Also, the dose reduction to 25 mg per kg body weight per day may necessary for neonate and the patient who have impaired liver or renal function. The use of chloramphenicol should be avoided for a prolonged treatment. The pharmacodynamic completely absorbed from gastrointestinal tract. The bioavailability is 80%, well tolerated, and it will bind with the plasma protein 50 to 60% in adult and 30% in premature neonate. The hepatic metabolism with 90% conjugate to inactive glucuronide. As you see in the diagram, the metabolic reaction will be shown, the major metabolism of the carb as in show in the just left side. The toxicity include fatalities. means these are occur in premature and newborn. Sign and symptom associated with the reaction like abdominal distension, emesis, progressive cyanosis, vasomotor collapse, frequently accompanied by irregular respiration. Death may be within few hours. The chloroform medically effective against the enteric bacteria and other gram-negative, gram-positive bacteria, Staphylococcus pneumoniae, Neisseria meningitis, Haemophilus influenzae, and Enterococcus faecalium. The medicine chemistry, as we see, is an organochlorine compound contains a nitrobenzene ring and has an antimicrobial bacterial by protein synthesis inhibitor. It is also effective against the tetracycline resistant fibrosis, and it is also used in eye drop ointment to the bacterial conjunctivitis. The chloroform is produced from Staphylococcus aureus in the following pathway as shown in the diagram. That means chlorismic acid, it lead to form the amino phenyl alanine, then lead to amino phenyl serine, which lead to form dichloroacetyl, then it will lead to form amino phenyl stearine, then it lead to form a chloroform. The chloroform relatively simple compound having a two asymmetric carbon atom means there are four isomers possible to exist. As you see in the structure, the dextro-3O isomer, which is active against the antibacterial activity, apart from the other three are inactive, and the dextro-3O isomer is only active. The stereochemistry shows the active isomer. The structural activity relationship, as in the diagram, the replacement phenyl group by aromatic or acyclic system, shifting of nitro from para position lead to loss of the activity. So the position of nitro group should not be changed. The replacement of hydroxyl group, extension or suppression at the terminal will also abolish the activity. The replacement of dichloro group by azide group gives active compound as azadafenicol. The toxicity mainly chloroform, that is, when it is used for a long time, it will cause reversible agranulocytosis and thrombocytopenia, and the effect on the liver, it may cause hematotoxicity due to formation of nitroso and hydroxyl amine. Due to reduction of a aromatic nitro group, which is a reversible, so the treatment should be discontinued. It may also cause gray baby syndrome. A syndrome called show toxicity of antibiotic chloroform in the newborn, especially in the premature newborn, because lack of the necessary liver enzyme to metabolize the drug. Chloroform accumulate in the baby cause hypertension. It may also cause a bacterial resistance. Certain strains of bacteria produce this, and there are prodrug of chloroform are possible. Chloroform diffuses through bacterial cell wall, reversibly bind to bacterial 50th subunit ribosomal unit. As a result, bacterial protein synthesis is blocked and impaired bacterial cell proliferation. Chloroform palmitate and chloroform hemisuccinates are possibility of the prodrug of the chloroform. The chloroform palmitate is given in the form of suspension whereas chloramphenicol succinate is given by injection either intramuscular or intravenous. The use of chloramphenicol, it is a bacteriostatic, bactericide, choice of drug in the typhoid, and it will a broad spectrum, effective against the gram-positive and anaerobe, and it is a potential for serious limitation. The chloramphenicol is an excellent drug that in the treatment of typhoid, parathyroid, thyroid fever, and haemophilus. It is a safer antibiotic we use whenever possible in case of pneumococcal and meningococcal and meningitis in beta-lactam allergic patient. Thanks a lot. Have a nice time.